Yates of Australia, an exhibition by Dirk Yates. Boss Kevin's really pleased to have this exhibition here. And double thanks for coming to the arts talk. So, I guess I've had the privilege of having a number of conversations over leading up to this show, so hopefully we can kind of build on that and also encourage everyone to contribute as well. So we might start off, I guess, talking about the decisions in kind of adjusting the space, particularly in painting the space. I guess if anyone hasn't been to a box copy before, usually it has white walls. So yeah, can you tell us a little bit about your choices in painting the space?
So I guess I'll just talk like a little bit about how I approached the exhibition and how it kind of came to be like this. But like when I first came to the space, like looking at works in here, it's kind of odd where things were kind of like a central object within this kind of old office space that had been painted white and was converted from its previous use and then made into a gallery. And I always had this kind of but an odd sense coming in here, like walking from home, like over the Goodwill Bridge and down George Street, then getting onto Margaret Street, seeing this old brown brick building, and coming up those stairs, and then kind of entering this space that had been kind of painted out white. We still get these traces of the like picture rails and like the old doors and like another door that had been covered over. And it's this kind of sense that we kind of felt like it was to forget like everything else that had just happened before entering the room and just focus on the kind of object in front. There was always this kind of thing in the back of my mind about this kind of falseness of setting up. It felt like a kind of neutral laws, kind of objective space that was kind of meant to be there or be here.
We talked about neutrality a bit early on because you were saying that it's almost like the gallery's sort of attempt to create a neutral space as the white cube or the sort of walls and white cube, but then that potentially like this could be more neutral or like returning it to kind of like this environment.
Yeah, so like the initial idea was just to stand back the walls to the colours that you guys first came across the room, and then like through practical reasons this painting it back is a way to kind of make this back into a room rather than trying to be a gallery, like a kind of idea of what a purpose-built gallery is meant to be. So it's just like the art ends up kind of being here as well. It's not about trying to disguise the rest of the building as something that it's not. And I think that kind of was exemplified in like the previous show where it's like markets in the gallery where you kind of have these kind of perfect cubes and like the walls are kind of perfect. Like perfectly flat without these kinds of things. It's kind of like the solution that these other things are meant to go away.
Yeah, that was, I think, something interesting for me earlier on, because in sort of returning to maybe the space, or at least the colour scheme in the walls with the same colour of the space, and the office prior to Box W, was like you're interested in the history of the space, but on to a point that was sort of, wasn't about kind of a complete fiction or kind of like returning it to being an office entirely. It was also kind of keeping a balance between still as a gallery as well.
Yeah, I think just like looking at the latent kind of aspects already in the space, so just like the fact that it's in an old building is kind of curious, but then like when you come here during the rest of the week, the guys set up a kind of table in the corner where the gallery sits, but I think generally kind of exhibitions are set up so that kind of isn't meant to be seen or acknowledged. And so like part of the strategy was to put the gallery sitter in the centre of the room and make them kind of active component into the way which you engage with the other work in the room. So like in a way they become part of the medium.
Yeah.
Right. Seeing something in like
just, I guess someone sort of set the space that is kind of awkward, I think it's supposed to be there, but you are.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's very interesting, like it's an active ingredient kind of between like office and gallery. So.
Yeah, and like rather than trying to deny like practicalities of not having a purpose-built space, it's just kind of like letting it play out and maybe taking advantage of it in a way that when you come here, you feel more comfortable engaging with the person that's kind of keeping safe the art in a way that you can actually
guess then moving from like this sort of transformation to face, I can kind of see it as a really interesting way of like framing kind of objects or how people kind of relate to the art objects or the paintings. So I don't know, like I just sort of feel like if it kind of works in that way of sort of in framing discussions or framing kind of like an approach to unpacking other things.
Yeah, I think so. Like, so part of it is, I think some of the discussions that I had kind of make, kind of addressing your work that's shown, like in this gallery, like sometimes is this kind of universal idea about engaging with art. And I think this kind of like regional ideas of dealing with place that maybe get carried on through other parts of life into the way in which you engage with art as well. So, like in terms of taking an existing room and painting it up all white if nothing was there, kind of is reminiscent to other transformations, I think, of the landscape. But you still get those traces of this used previously. So, like rather than mimicking that, in like this kind of colonial way of looking at landscape, it's like a like an alternative, just accepting it, making the most of the kind of space it is. So how we you might like consider looking at art in Brisbane as being a thing where you look at it in terms of a universal idea about what art is. It's trying to look at art in Brisbane in the context of being in Brisbane.
Yeah, because there is always that idea that like you, like as an artist perhaps, like you approach the light space or the light cube as a site where potentially kind of making something for the world. Exist in that space. So I think it's something interesting. Kind of like knowing almost that to have an exhibition in Brisbane, you could, you know, sort of know who's going to turn up and see it, or you sort of understand it, like, I guess, a locality sort of is important.
Yeah.
It's,
and yeah, so I think like the like in some ways, like just trying to like the like one of the reasons for using the flag is the way in which it is a symbol that kind of groups people indiscriminately in a way, like as it attempts to anyway, I think. But then like making a proposition which maybe that's problematic, like whether it's something that's just assumed and kind of just allowed to happen, or whether you provide a question, I think it spills out into other kind of dilemmas about social groupings that are beyond the representation or an image that represents a group of people. And I think that obviously tends to be like a local kind of knowledge or reading that like allows those things to happen.
Yeah.
So it's not so much a universal thing, but kind of regional in a way of looking at a flag, which is like an image.
And on that kind of inability for